What's up, guys? Out of Towners TV here. Today we are out on the rocks, fishing a little bit south of Carmel, north of Big Sur. But it's a little bit of break in the high swells. Oh, there's a dead cormorant. You see this, Dad? The dead cormorant?
Yeah.
Man. Never been to a spot that had a bird that didn't hit, so that's always a good sign. Supposed to be a little bit calmer swells. It's still rough today, but compared to what we've been having the last few months, it's definitely an improvement. So we wanted to take that chance to get out here and get down on the rocks and try our luck for some rockfish, maybe some perch. Basically, we're gonna be casting down off this cliff and walking along this trail here, trying out different spots throughout the day. So we're gonna get into it right now. We're just gonna get set up here on the rocks. This point out here looks like it's got a lot of different options to get poles casted out in different directions. There's a couple rocks out here that might help us out with protecting our bait. You can see over here, there's a bit of a calmer section. So I'm definitely gonna be putting my first rods in behind that rock. I need to tighten my hat down, dude. Yeah. A little breezy. Whoops. All right, so we got a high-low rig here with the rockfish shrimp flies. Here you go. Yeah, you could probably just put squid on it and drop it straight down off here.
I should bait them?
Yeah, you should put bait on there. Yeah, I can feel the bottom right here. Just giving it a jiggy. Make sure I don't snag on anything. Oh, there it is, snag. Now I broke it. Current's super cooked right here. Any more weight. All right, my swim bait's getting tossed around out there, so I'm gonna step it up on the weight size. Swapped it out for about a half ounce jig head. High risk for snagging, but let's get down there and risk it for the biscuit. Conditions aren't great, so we might be packing up and switching spots here in a little bit, but yeah, the water seems pretty rough, honestly. But we got a whole day ahead of us fishing all the way to sundown, which corresponds with the low tide, negative 1.7 feet today. So we're gonna keep working at it, keep plugging away. Ah, it's water's so cooked. I wonder how it looks on the other side of that cliff. Try and get this bait right down below. There's gotta be fish right here, bro. It's just the current's a little strong. They're there. All right, well, the spot's seeming pretty cursed right now, honestly. It's broke off third time. I think we're about ready to call over here, keep walking along that coast and see if we can find a better spot, a little more protected. Bound around over the top of that cliff over there. Looks like there's another place, so we're heading there. Keep that smile, man. Day's still long. All right, making our way around the horn right now. What's the game plan, dog?
Bait, swim.
Baits and swimming.
Shrimps.
Anything I want right now, a fish probably wants too. Hopefully around that corner is more protected. The surf down here on the exposed side of the ocean is absolutely cooked. You wanna go down there?
Nah, hell no.
All right, this is spot number two down there on that rock. I'm gonna head along this path and walk out across it. Water is incredibly blue. This looks like a good spot. ¿Qué tal? ¿Todo bien? ¿Pescaste algo?
Perch.
Perch? Okay.
How are you?
Nah. He said his homie caught two perch. What bait is he using, squid? Shrimp? Shrimp. Woo! Verga. Woo! Salty. Switching to shrimp. Oh, that's our last shrimp?
No, some more. We got one more.
I'll take a perch gladly.
Otra? They're slaying over here, bro. Mi amigo te pregunto si quiere cambiar lugares. Cash out there, doggy. Yep. Bruh, this dude's cracked. You got a kelp greenling. Nice, yeah. He's locked in that honey hole. La buena. We just gotta get a little taste of the honey, man. Just want a little dabble. Getting bites. Yeah.
Así es para la playa.
Ajá.
Pero nosotros lo ponemos aquí, así, y luego lo amarramos acá.
Ok.
Sí, ahí trabaja esto, pero aquí no, aquí debe ser así, fijo de aquí.
Ok, voy a cambiar.
Sí.
Gracias. Creo que están comiendo la camarones que tengo.
¿Así?
Sí. He said high, low. Yeah. Tide's dropped a bit, so put two pieces of squid in here. I'm gonna walk out, try and fish those tide pool spots because we have not gotten a single bite here on the rocks. So, mira. Woo! ¿Cuántos? So I
seis.
Ooh. Those guys are super nice. They let me try and fish into the spot next to them. They're feeling bad for us because we haven't gotten a single bite. So they let us try and sneak in on the side of their honey hole. We were still casting off the shelf a little bit further from where they were. So we couldn't get a single bite, but I think they're about to leave. So we're going to sneak in there. But for now, I'm just looking at these little tide pool spots. And if anything, there are a decent amount of mussels. I don't know if I'll be trying to grab them, but a bit of a tasty snack could be. We weaseled them off the spot. And we're flocking to a spot like a bunch of vultures. Come on, guys. We can do it, guys. Come on. Come on, Max. We got the honey hole, bro. It's ours now. Come on. They gave you more shrimp?
Yeah.
Let me get some of that. Oh, yeah. We're in it. Go. Oh, yeah. That's right in the money zone. Using some of these limpets as bait. White pole? All right, I'll check it. Fish on? No way. Ooh, it looks like a good fish. No, it's there, it's there. Careful with the rocks. Where's it at? He's right here, close. Try and flip him up. Oh no, dude. Perch? Nice, that's a good one. Yeah, flip him up.
Ooh, that's beautiful.
Beautiful perch. Let's go! We beat the skunk! We beat the skunk!
Wow, I didn't know those things were so
Pretty big. Nice!
So I used a tiny piece of shrimp. I thought, I'm gonna try a tiny piece of shrimp.
Nice perch.
Yeah, beauty.
Put them into the little, oh! Put them into the aquarium there.
My cast went super far out there that time and it just immediately took it.
He's big?
Yeah. No skunk. All right, I'm gonna try and do this relatively quickly because there's been some big breakers coming, but there's definitely some good looking mussels here. Uh-oh. So you're only allowed to grab these and harvest them by hand. So that's why I'm down here doing it without a tool. A lot of different sizes here. There's a huge, kind of gnarly looking one. I'm gonna avoid that. Some of these ones in the cracks are really hard to grab out though, so. Usually you give them a little twist like that and they pop out.
It's an easy way not to skunk right there.
All right, that's it for today. Got this nice golden hour coming through right now. Definitely got sun-kissed. It was a long day. We fished from 10 a.m. to 5. Yeah, we pulled up around, you know, tried two spots. Saw some people that definitely knew what they were doing more than us. We were able to catch that one perch, so I'm gonna take that back and fry that up. And I definitely have something in mind with those mussels. So we're gonna get our stuff packed up and head on out of here. And I'll see you guys back in the kitchen. Guys, we're back in the kitchen. We got all our food set out in front of us. I already got the mussels scrubbed and cleaned. The meal I'm making sounds a little bit strange. Basically, what we're gonna be doing is using the fat from chorizo, cooking it down in a pan, and of course, throwing in some scallions and tomatoes, garlic, bring that all together. So at the end, when we put in the mussels and they open up and let out their ocean juices into the sauce, that whole flavor profile comes through. So you get a good mix of fat, salt, and of course, a little acidity from the lemons that we put in at the end. So the way I've decided to serve it today is preparing some linguine pasta. We'll be taking the cooked finished product, putting it on top of the mussels, drizzling the sauce, make sure none of it's going to waste. And as for the perch, I'm gonna get that thing scaled up and we're gonna be whole frying the perch today. Just a little bit of salt, keep it simple. I'm gonna be using avocado oil. That's one of my preferred oils for fish frying. This meal is gonna cook really fast once all the vegetables are prepped, so stay tuned.
Oh yeah. Fish. Worth all the struggle. Nice orange meat.
Well, that's it for this one. If you made it this far, you might as well stick around and subscribe. Jeez, my voice is cooked. Stick around and subscribe for more content. We got videos coming out at least once a month.